Welcome to our training on Android. We're going to get started with Fragments in this particular session. We're going to understand what exactly Fragments is. Android Fragments were added to the Android API in Honeycomb API 11, and they are even supported in Android 1.6 API number 4 via the compatibility package. This section discusses Fragments for Android 3.0 or higher. Fragments are reusable components and they allow for better UI designs such as cards and floating action buttons. Fragments are well suited for a master design UI design as well as dynamic layouts to accommodate various screen sizes and configurations. So now you can understand Fragments are important because they can let you create layouts like master detail UI design and they can support multiple screen size and configurations for phones as well as tablets. Another important point is that the instantiation of a new activity can be time consuming compared to a fragment. So it could be possible that the time which you take to create an activity and the time which you take to create a fragment has a huge difference. So always, whenever time is concerned, you can get started with creation of a fragment. Think of a fragment as a piece of an application's user interface or behavior that can be placed in an activity. Interaction with fragments is done through Fragment Manager, which is available via the Activity class as well, and that's a static method getFragmentManager which you can call. You can also use getFragmentManager from the Fragment class as well. In essence, the Fragment class represents a particular operation or interface that is running within a larger activity. A fragment is closely tied to its enclosing activity and cannot be used apart from an activity. So it is very clear that you cannot use fragments without an activity. You need to have a mother component, an activity available, and within this activity you can create fragments. Although a fragment defines its own life cycle, that life cycle is dependent on its activity. If the activity is stopped, no fragments inside of it can be started. When the activity is destroyed, all fragments will also be destroyed. All subclasses of fragment must include a public empty constructor, which is needed whenever the framework reinstantiates a fragment class, such as during state restore. If the empty constructor is unavailable, a runtime exception will occur in some cases during state restore. Activities and fragments have a one-to-many relationship. A best practice is to use at most 4 or 5 fragments in an activity, but nothing will stop you from using many more. In general, use an activity to launch existing Android resources. You can launch video player, browser, and so forth. And use a fragment to modify the UI components of an application. Now, activities and fragments have, since they have one to many, so you need to note that fragment subclasses must include a public empty constructor, otherwise a runtime exception will occur. There are some related classes to fragments, and all these classes are available within android.app package. So you can import android.app package in order to use the fragment class, and the fragment class has the following content available. These are the subclasses. You can have a dialog fragment, you can have a list fragment, you can have preference fragment, and you can have web view fragment. Google recommends the use of fragments which can be used as containers for activities. Fragment make it easier to reuse components in different layouts. Since Android 4, that is your ice cream sandwich, it supports both smartphones and tablets. You can deploy the same Android application in both devices. However, the visual display will probably be different on these two devices, and fragments provide a nice solution. Although fragments are not mandatory, they do make it easier to support multiple screen sizes. Now I would like to show you the activity life cycle or the life cycle of a fragment. So as soon as you add a fragment, onAttach method is executed, then your onCreate method gets executed, onCreateView gets executed, onActivityCreated gets executed, then onStart, onResume, and finally your fragment is active. Once your fragment is active, either a user can click backward key and the fragment can be removed or replaced from the screen. And once he comes back to the screen, the fragment will again be loaded. So once, if he goes out of the fragment or the activity, the following methods will be called: onPause, onStop, onDestroyView. From this onDestroyView, the fragment returns to the layout from the back stack. if the user exits the application or if he destroys the activity, then the onDestroy method will be called. Later, onDetach will be called, in which your fragment will be detached from the activity, and finally your fragment is destroyed. So all these functions are available which you can use or override in order to perform specific tasks at different situations within the fragment lifecycle. So now I hope you are understood with what exactly a fragment is. So you are clear with it's a component which can be associated with activities, and it is majorly used for creating better UI which can support different form factor of devices. I hope you understood the concept of fragments. In the next session, we'll proceed to fragments in much details, and we are going to develop practical applications with fragments. Thank you for watching.